to introduce to you Stephen Mead. He's the CEO at Moneta Pro, which is a B2B fintech platform for the $17 trillion industry of corporate barter or non-cash trading. Can you please give him a very warm welcome to the stage?
I guess this is a benefit of being ready to go. They mic'd me up in 30 seconds, but let's just get started. Did you know there is a $17 trillion existing industry of what's called global non-cash trading or corporate barter, according to the United Nations? This consists of all kinds of trades. Companies trade goods for services, computers for cars, airlines for hotels. And this activity, the average transaction is over $1.5 million. So this is a massively pre-existing market. But the market's a little fragmented and it's inefficient. And what I mean by that is the way these trades occur is phone, fax, and email. Companies will make a call and try and find somebody. So here's an example of Ford who wants to trade with Lenovo for computers. It doesn't just happen automatically. They have to negotiate an equal value. They have to consummate the trade. They have to track the assets. They have to report it. It's very manual, difficult, and cumbersome. And you might ask yourself, if it's so difficult, why don't companies just use cash? Well, there's a lot of reasons. Financial leverage, tax advantages, and full retail. Here's what I mean by that. If you own $1 million worth of cars, one of your options at the end of the year is to mark it down, sell it and pay cash, and then pay taxes. In the trade world, you actually trade it at full value. So you get tremendous financial leverage. You also improve cash flow. If I trade $1 million worth of cars and receive $1 million worth of computers, I do not spend cash to acquire that asset. That means that cash stays on my books, remains on my balance sheet, sits in my sweep account earning interest. And the third one is what's called asset management. If I have computers at the end of the year, the last thing I want to do is discount them and kill my margin for a new buyer who might be coming in at a new model year. So this is a massive industry, but it's still automated. It's not automated, it's offline. So what is Moneta Pro? We've created what's called a one-to-many trade platform. Very simple, almost like an internal eBay. With Moneta Pro, you list assets. What you receive in return is what we created called a GBUC. It stands for a global business usage credit. And you actually use that GBUC, that credit, to acquire other assets within the marketplace. And I want to spend just a second on it. The GBUC, to be clear, is not a blockchain credit. It's an internal ledger. It's like a store credit in Amazon or eBay, which technically means it's immediate financial settlement, no volatility. The GBUC within the system equals $1. So if I sell an asset, I receive a credit. I can buy assets from another party in another country and not worry about currency fluctuation risks. There's no volatility. The credits stay within the system. That's what a closed-loop system means. So Moneta Pro technically solves three major problems for companies in this industry. The exchange that we've created solves automation. Companies now, instead of having to call, phone, fax, email, can list an asset, sell it, require it back. But within there are two big problems. If I sell or trade assets, they're off books. They don't show up in my accounting system. And when the auditors come in, there's a problem if $1 million worth of inventory is missing. So we're using the private blockchain internally just to A, prove asset transfers, and B, prove audit trail. That private blockchain enables a company to simply have the compliance officers know that those assets were traded, not stolen or purposely removed. Very simple solution. And for us, we're a traditional e-commerce model. We make money on the transaction fee, charging the seller, and it collects electronically at the time of sale. Massive market, great opportunity. Well, here's the status. Moneta Pro, the systems are complete. We actually have an operating system. It's built. It functions in multiple layers, hierarchies, divisions, departments. You can move assets around. Active pipeline of customers that we're in discussions with now to bring on. For a little bit of reference, I started this company conceptually in the year 2000. I tried to build what I called a GBUC, a global business usage currency. And nobody in the world understood it. And we think the timing is right now. And then also Moneta Pro comes from the cowrie seashells. Earlier, if you guys saw blockable. They talked about the evolution of barter to currency. First form of portable currency was the Moneta seashell, which was the evolution after barter. And that's what we believe we are. So we put together a team. Everybody talks about their team. I'm going to do a little bit of the same, but 25 years experience on our technology team. Gil comes out of not only 4 years of integrated blockchain experience, but also transaction processing. Jay Sato on the marketing team launched $3 billion divisions of Sony. Robert Jacobson, we're kind of excited about this. I was talking to a few of my friends that I won't mention names, but I believe we might be the first one to have presented a position called a director of PR. Any of you that have looked at public companies have an investor relations director, a director of IR. And I looked at this and said, we need a token relations director. We need somebody specifically handling communication with the potential investors. And Robert fills that role. He actually comes out of the finance industry and the venture industry. So we put a director of TR on. Rick Prendergast on the sales team, 25 years building American Express. Igor Barash, COO, took his first company public out of his garage to the NASDAQ called Cyber Defender. Advisors, we're adding a few more, but banking. Roger Van Scoy, head of First Data Global Card Operations. Steve Mott, MasterCard New Technologies. Richard Titus, those of you that know Richard, I actually include Richard in not for his crypto experience, but his media experience. Media component is a $6 to $8 billion aspect of media companies trading. So we did very specific industry advisors that we brought on. Jeff Hazlett, some of you know, CMO of Kodak. Steve Beauregard, Greg Morrow. And then finally, the token offering. This is an investor presentation. This is an investor conference. So here's where we are for the investor. Our first round was $1 million. We used that to sort of get everything finalized. We're in the $4 million round now. It's a 25-cent pre-offering. We're calling it the pre-ICO. We believe our next round will be at $10 million. That's more of a strategic offering, going after corporations, strategic partners. And if we get to the point, we'll do a $20 million at the end, which is a public ICO. Tokenomics are created. We can share any of that with you in terms of the breakdown. Most importantly, I created something I call a double appreciation bonus. For the contributors that come in now, we're not looking to do bonuses, affiliates. Basically, it works like this. If you come in now, appreciation one is we'll say thank you. That's our appreciation. But two, I will recap any of your investments on March 31st if the asset you invest in has gone up. We know that crypto's gone down, so we're looking to reinvest. At the 31st, we'll retokenize or recapitalize your investment. $35 million round, $4 million is our early contribution. We actually have Squire Patton Boggs, the fifth largest law firm, on team for SAFT, accredited investor, 6 month hold. Options for the investor, two paths. One, exit to the Moneta Pro token. Two, we've got some listings on an exchange. Last things finishing up, we created a corporate benevolence program where we believe companies can take the credits at the end of the year, donate them to nonprofits as a way to shift tax liability. And in closing, we won D10E Silicon Valley. If you want to back another winner, that's Moneta Pro. Thank you.